A very good morning to one and all of you. Today I am going to discuss about antibody testing in COVID-19. So how does this serological testing help us in COVID-19 diagnosis and also to improve patient outcomes? So first thing, I will discuss about the indications of antibody testing in COVID-19. The first indication is late presentations. So you see, we have seen India, many patients, they come very late to the hospital. So if any patients come with COVID suspect symptoms, so after 9 days of illness, so usually they present the second week, usually after 9 days of illness. So at the time, if you do the swab test, so either if you do RT-PCR or rapid antigen test, it will be negative. So the positivity decreases in the second week. So usually when they came late, they came after 9 days or 10 days to the hospital. So if you want to diagnose COVID-19 in those patients, antibody testing helps a lot. So then the serological test will provide us the answer. The second indication is it helps us to identify patients who previously had COVID-19 infection. The third indication is patients who have current infection, who had symptoms for 3 to 4 weeks. The fourth indication is it can be considered patients who have COVID suspect symptoms, who have repeated negative NAT tests. So whenever you do RT-PCR, if you repeat it also, repeatedly the RT-PCR will come negative. And still if you suspect COVID in that patients, you can go for antibody testing after 7 days of symptom onset. So antibody testing also helps us to establish diagnosis in patients who present with late complications COVID-19, such as multisystem inflammatory syndrome in children. And antibody testing helps us a lot to establish diagnosis in patients with post-acute COVID-19 syndrome. As you can see, right now, a lot of patients are thronging our outpatient chambers. So they're telling a lot of complaints. See, some people, they're saying, so I had fever some 30 days back. Just it's a low-grade fever. It's nothing much. Even I haven't used Paracetamol. The next day, the fever disappeared. Then the cough started, and cough is persisting since 30 days. So some other patient is saying, I'm having existential breathlessness. So when I climb stairs, when I do some exertion work, I feel breathless. So another patient is saying, I'm having chest pain. Some other patient is saying, I'm having vertigo. Another patient is saying, I'm having headache. Another patient, I'm having sleeplessness. One patient is saying, I'm having fatigue since 30 days. I had a history of fever for one day, a low-grade fever for one day, 30 days back. And he's having extreme fatigue. Literally, he's unable to do his routine work. So they're saying a lot of complaints, and they haven't got tested during their period of illness. So antibody testing helps us a lot to establish a diagnosis in patients presenting with post-acute COVID-19 syndrome. Like they're coming with persistent cough, persistent breathlessness, persistent chest pains. So since 30 days or 40 days, some people complaining of sleeplessness, generalized weakness, headaches, vertigo, dizziness, and so on. So many post-COVID acute-19 syndromes. So antibody test helps us a lot to establish a diagnosis in such cases. Some people complain of bloating, epigastric pain, and burning sensation in the retrosternal area. So in this, all these things, antibody test helps us a lot to establish the diagnosis. Even as you can see, the thrombotic complications of COVID-19 have a late presentation. See, I have seen many cases of MIs, myocardial infarctions, and cerebrovascular accidents. They're presenting literally 30 days after symptom onset. Some people presenting even after 40 days of symptom onset. So when you come across an MI, say a thrombotic event like myocardial infarction or cerebrovascular accident in brain strokes, or if people come with DVT, or some people come with arterial thrombosis. So you can get a serological test, you can get an antibody test, which helps us diagnose, oh, this patient got COVID-19 one month back, this patient got COVID-19 two months back. So it's the late thrombotic complications of COVID-19. So like that, antibody test helps us a lot. And antibody testing is very useful in sero surveillance studies, in sero prevalence studies for research and public health monitoring. As you can see, ICMR conducts the sero surveillance studies. So right now we know that almost 30% of people got infected in India. So antibody testing helps a lot who got exposed to the COVID-19 virus. So antibody testing helps us to monitor the quality and also longevity of immune response in a patient with confirmed COVID-19 infection. And antibody test helps a lot in vaccination research. See, whenever you vaccinate a patient, so if you want to know the vaccine works or not, whether it has developed antibodies or not, you should go for antibody testing. And the final indication is if you want to check whether a person is eligible for convalescent plasma donation, you should check the antibody titers. So antibody testing helps us a lot. So the next question is, why antibody tests? So it can supplement this RT-PCR assays in the diagnosis of acute COVID-19. See, viral shedding in the upper respiratory system profoundly decreases 7 to 10 days after infection. That's why when patients come late to the hospital, usually in the second week, usually after 10 days or something like that, usually the swab test becomes negative. So at the time, antibody test helps in the diagnosis of the acute COVID-19. And usually this antibody test helps us to diagnose cases. So after 5 to 7 days of symptom onset, we have negative RT-PCR test. However, antibody tests will not replace direct pathogen detection because the immunological response triggered by an acute infection, such as COVID-19, has a certain latency. Usually it takes 5 to 7 days to develop antibodies. So antibody testing is not useful when the patient comes in the first week. So usually it is useful when the patient comes late to the hospital after 9 to 10 days and so on. These serological tests are less likely to be reactive in the first several days to weeks after infection. So they have limited utility in diagnosis in acute settings. Checking serology 3 to 4 weeks after symptom onset optimizes the accuracy of testing. Consider serological testing to determine potential exposure rather than a sole basis for diagnosis of acute COVID-19. Antibodies may take time to develop, usually 7 to 10 days after symptom onset. Serological testing alone should not be used to establish presence or absence of SARS coronavirus 2 infection or reinfection. So which test? So IDSA recommends IgG antibody tests or total antibody test rather than IgA or IgM antibody test. So as you know, three main types of antibodies are produced: IgA, IgM, and IgG. IgM rises soonest and typically declines after infection. IgA and IgG persist and usually reflect long-term immune response. Serological testing detecting IgA are not recommended. So as you can see in the picture, so IgM is usually detected 5 to 7 days after infection and IgG usually after 14 days of infection. So IgG persists for months. So, and again, if the patient is reinfected, so IgM helps us in diagnosis rather than IgG. So what are the methods used to test for antibodies? You can use lateral flow assays like immunochromatography, ELISA, CLIA, ELFA. So of these, this ELISA, CLIA, and ELFA are the best. But this immunochromatographic assays, lateral flow assays, are point of care tests, which can be done just, you can get the result in 15 minutes. But rest tests require very specialized laboratory equipment and also trained lab personnel. These are binding tests that detect SARS coronavirus 2 antigens, nucleocapsid or spike protein. So timeline. So usually detectable antibodies, they take around 5 to 7 days to develop after infection. So the IgM sensitivity. So you can detect IgM in 23% of patients in first week, 58% by 2 weeks, 75% by 3 weeks. IgG sensitivity, 30% by 1 week, in 66% by 2 weeks, in 88% by 3 weeks, usually 100% by 16 to 20 days. So now I'll tell you how to interpret molecular, serologic, and clinical testing. So it will help us to identify the phase of infection. So in which stage of infection are you? The first scenario, RT-PCR positive, IgM positive, IgG negative. So there were a chance of high infection. They can infect others. So it interprets as the patient is in early stage of infection. RT-PCR positive, IgM positive, IgG positive. The patient is highly infectious. It indicates that patient is in active phase of infection. RT-PCR positive, IgM negative, IgG positive. A patient is infectious. It indicates that patient is in late stage of infection. RT-PCR positive, IgM negative, IgG negative. Patient is infectious. It indicates that patient is in window period. RT-PCR negative, IgM positive, IgG negative, patient is infectious, it indicates patient is in early stage of infection with false negative RT-PCR. RT-PCR negative, IgM negative, IgG positive, patient is infectious, it indicates late stage of infection with false negative RT-PCR. RT-PCR negative, IgM negative, IgG positive, patient is not infectious, it indicates that patient had past infection. RT-PCR negative, IgM positive, IgG positive, patient is not infectious, it indicates that patient is in convalescence with false negative RT-PCR. RT-PCR negative, IgM negative, IgG negative, patient is infectious, it indicates that patient is in window period with false negative RT-PCR. So these are the different combinations where you can, so using molecular and serological testing, you can predict patient is in which phase of infection, whether patient is in late stage or early stages, patient is in window period, whether patient is infectious or not. So you can use these interpretations to establish the clinical outcomes. Specificity. In contrast with IgG antibody tests and also total antibody tests, IgM, IgA and IgM-IgG differentiation tests generally have specificities below 99%. So what are the limitations of antibody testing? So these antibody tests, they may cross-react with antibodies of already 6 known human coronaviruses. So we know that already 4 human coronaviruses which are endemic to humans, and also we have SARS coronavirus 1 and also MERS. So they can cross-react with antibodies of these viruses. And also other viral pathogens. See, something like dengue is belongs to different family, but some it can have cross reaction with dengue antibody tests also. But right now, I went through this research paper published by Roach. It showed that Roach antibody assay exhibited no cross reactivity with endemic human coronavirus convalescent sera. So it's a good thing. In one study, at 8 weeks following infection, 40% of asymptomatic patients and 13% of symptomatic patients did not have detectable IgG. Serological testing alone should not be used to establish presence or absence of SARS coronavirus 2 infection or reinfection. IDSA says that serological testing is not recommended for diagnosis of SARS coronavirus 2 infection during the first 2 weeks after symptom onset. Duration. See, duration of these detectable antibodies is still uncertain. The research is going on. So at present, some research paper says that usually these antibodies last for 3 months, but we don't know. So more research is going on. As days progress, we get more data. In one study, IgG antibodies react to in 90% with titers increasing over the first 2 months after diagnosis and remaining steady for another 2 months. So usefulness. So where is this antibody test very useful? See, antibody test is very useful when patients come late to the hospital. So they come after 9 to 10 days after symptom onset, and also some people, asymptomatic people, oligosymptomatic people, or patients having subclinical infections. In this patient's antibody test helps us to establish the diagnosis of COVID-19. And with this, we can also, it also helps us to identify individuals who may have immunity to infection. So immunity passport. So right now, so there are a lot of discussions going on immunity passport. But as of now, we don't have much research regarding how much long this immunity lasts for SARS coronavirus 2. Until more data is available, CDC recommends that results of antibody testing not to be used to determine rooming arrangements in congregate settings, such as dormitories or prisons, make decisions about return to work or alter works, and for PPE requirement for healthcare workers. So these are the references and further reading. If you have any doubts regarding antibody testing COVID-19, please drop a comment below this YouTube section, and whenever I'm free, I will reply. And please subscribe to my YouTube channel, and I'll make more medical videos. Thank you.